Hi friends, welcome to JS Framework. So today we'll be taking a look at what role the ZoneJS library plays in the Angular framework. The core concept of ZoneJS is the zone, which is a mechanism which can be used to track and intercept the asynchronous activities which occur in a browser. So these activities can be anything like the timers, like set timeout, set interval, or the promises and all. The zone provides a execution context in which we will be able to track and intercept the asynchronous activities and also perform some related tasks like change detection based on the starting and completion of the activities. There are three kinds of tasks which can be scheduled in a zone context. So these are the macro task, the micro task, and the event task. Macro task is a task which usually results in a rendering of the browser, and it will usually take one complete cycle of the event loop. And the example of a macro task is a timer function like set timeout or set interval, or it can be an XHR call. Another kind of task is the micro task. Micro task is usually something like a promise.resolve, which will be executed immediately after the current executing script. Macro task can be canceled. However, the micro task cannot be canceled. And similarly, there is another category of task which is present in the zone context, that is the event task. This usually refers to a method like the add event listener, which you usually call to add listeners for events like the click event or the change event or anything similar. So this can also be cancelled using the corresponding event handlers. So let's take a look at how ZoneJS keeps track of these asynchronous activities which happen in the browser. So as you can see, for each of the asynchronous activities like the APIs which introduce them, ZoneJS has created monkey patches for them. Like for example, the timers. So these include the set timeout, the set interval, and the set immediate, as well as their counterparts for clearing. So they have individually patched each of these methods, and basically they convert them into a task so that they can actively track the start and completion of these tasks. So now let's take a look at how Angular and ZoneJS combine together. So Angular has its own wrapper on ZoneJS called the NgZone. So basically what it does is it creates a new zone. So the fork method creates a new zone, and the name of the zone is Angular, which has some properties as well, and it also has some callbacks which are inherent to the ZoneJS. So as you can see, there is a on invoke task and on invoke, and these are usually called when the task is started, and on has task usually checks whether any tasks are pending, and on handler usually happens whenever something bad happens in the callback of the task. So the NgZone is provided as a injectable by Angular. So there are four life cycles which we can tap into in the NgZone service. So these are the on unstable, on micro task empty, on stable, and on error. So let's see when these will be called by NgZone. So if we go back to the Angular zone, you can see the on invoke task and the on invoke. So if you go into on enter, you can see that whenever a new task, a macro task is started, the on unstable event is emitted. If we go into the on leave method, you can see that it checks for the stability of the zone, and in case there are no pending task, it emits the micro task empty, and it will also set the on stable event. So this is how the NgZone lifecycle hooks work, and also in case of any error, it emits the on error event. So how does the Angular change detection run through zone? So it is actually quite simple. Inside the application reference file, they are listening to the on micro task empty event, and whenever that happens, they will be running the application ref.tick which will run the chain detection for the entire Angular application. I have created a sample Angular application so that we can get a better understanding of the NgZone lifecycle hooks. So I have basically subscribed to all the lifecycle hooks here with some console messages, and also I am calling a normal console log. I am calling a set timeout, and within that I am resolving a promise. Similarly, I am calling another timeout, a promise, and two request animation frames. Now let's run the application and see what happens. So you can see that initially the normal console got called and a chain detection was run. After that, the promise, which is a micro task, it gets executed, and again the chain detection runs, and the micro task queue became empty and the zone became stable. So again, the next time the request animation started, the zone became unstable and it was executed. The do check, that is the chain detection, was run, and again the similar life cycles are repeated. So this is basically what happens whenever a macro task runs. It the zone become unstable and it will execute all the life cycles till it becomes stable. So now let's see zone in action in case of a DOM event. So I have written a code to change the background color on click in a method, and I am also checking whether the current zone is Angular or not. So the code for this is like this. It is checking whether the current zone is having this property, and this property was set when the Angular zone was created. So when I click the page, you can see the same sequence of events which happened earlier. The zone became unstable and it's showing that it is running inside the Angular zone, and the chain detection runs and the zone becomes stable. Zone.js provides different levels at which we can either enable or disable the tracking of the asynchronous tasks. So if you check the polyfill.ts, they have provided multiple options which can be used to restrict certain asynchronous tasks. So for this purpose, we need to create a zone-flags file and call it before the zone.js is loaded. So let's try that. I have created a zone flag file. Inside that, I am going to disable the timers so that the set timeout and other related timers won't be covered inside the zone. So now when we see that when the set timeout is called, the zone related lifecycle hooks are not triggered, and it will be just it will not be covered as part of the automatic chain detection. Similarly, we can exclude certain DOM events using this unpatched events. So currently, for example, I am blocking the click event. So let's see what happens when I click the page. So you can see that the chain detection is not running, and it is showing that it is running outside the Angular zone. We can also disable zone at a global level. So this can be done in the main.ts file. So we have the option called ngZone, and if we give it as no operation, so none of the events will be covered under zone. So you can see that the chain detection is not run for anything. So whatever I do, the chain detection won't be triggered, and in these cases we need to manually trigger the chain detection so that our changes can be reflected in the UI. Now let us take a look at one of the most commonly used methods inside the ngZone. That's the run outside Angular. So this is usually used for performance improvement, like when we listen to events like mouse move or certain events which can be triggered multiple times in a short span of time. So in this scenario, I am running this particular command to generate the style within the run outside Angular, and I'll try to click the page. You can see that even though I placed it inside the run outside Angular, it is still calling the chain detection. This is because we gave the click event listener in the HTML. So since we gave it in the HTML, it will always run inside the Angular zone, because it is how it is internally written in Angular. So in case we need to run it properly outside Angular, so what we need to do is we will need to add the event listener in our code. So I have added the event listener here, and I will comment out this code. So now let's see what happens. So now you can see that the chain detection does not run, and it truly runs outside the Angular zone. So what happens inside the run outside Angular code? So let's go and see in the NgZone file. You can see that this particular command which we run, it is run in the outer zone. So the outer zone is the zone which was present before the Angular zone was created. So it is basically the parent zone. So all the lifecycle hooks which we saw earlier, they won't be covered in the outer zone. So that's how the chain detection does not trigger. Another commonly used command inside the NgZone service is the ngzone.run. So this is usually called when we need to include an event or asynchronous task that was run outside the Angular zone, and which we need to bring it into the Angular zone so that the chain detection will happen. So for the demo purpose, what I will do is I will go to the polyfill, the zone flag, and I will disable the click event. Now the click events will be running outside the Angular zone, but since I have added the ngzone run, they will be triggering the chain detection. So you can see that before the ngzone was run, the isAngular zone flag is false, and since it is run inside the Angular zone, it will be covered under the chain detection. So what happens under the run method is that it will be running the method inside the inner zone. So inner zone is basically the Angular zone, and it will be covered by the Angular chain detection. Now let us take a look at a scenario in which an error occurs within the ngzone run. So I have, for demo purpose, I have defined an invalid name here, and I am assigning a value here. So since the test is undefined, it will break the execution. So now I try to click the event. So what happens is the execution failed because of the undefined value. But you can see that the on error lifecycle was not triggered. So in order to get the on error trigger, what you need to do is you can run it as run guarded. So basically it is the same thing, but it will throw the error and we will be able to catch it in the on error block. So you can see here, you can see here that the error occurred in zone is displayed, which was present in our lifecycle hook, and I am displaying the error here. So we can also achieve this using the run task, which will run the same command as a task. So that will also call the on error lifecycle hook. So you can see another scenario which can occur is that there can be multiple DOM elements listening to the same event. For example, there are two handlers which are defined for the click event, and they are doing nothing, just logging a console. So what happens when we click the div? So I'm clicking it here. You can see that the chain detection ran twice for the same event. So Angular zone. The NgZone provides an option to merge these two handlers together and to run the chain detection once. So if we go to the main.ts, and add this flag, so now you can see that both the chain detection have been merged together, and it only runs one time. So this helps in improving the performance. Hope you found this video helpful. Please like and subscribe the video. Thank you.